Well, we're not broadcasting right now, so I'd say, what does Vladimir Putin's taste like?
This is a test of our ability to accept.
Okay,
I tell myself.
See if you accept this.
Yes.
Georgia and Iowa have gone for Donald Trump. How's that going? How's the accepting going? So, cheers.
To America.
Here's to democracy.
Yeah, in action.
Let me ask you a technical question that you guys, being political analysts, would know, you'd understand. What the is happening? What is happening out there? I haven't looked at anything in the last half hour. What's going on?
My sense is that this audience will not particularly like this, but he's now the front runner.
So what is that? What does that mean?
That means that he's
in electoral college, what does that mean?
Like, he has more paths now to 270 electoral votes than she does.
He had almost no path a week ago. So what has happened? Like, when I came in here, Florida had not been called. Has it been called?
Still has not been called. Is very close, but it looks like the amount of the lead that he has is probably going to be too much for her to surmount. So
okay,
right now,
so with Florida and Ohio,
two states now are front and center that we weren't talking about a week ago: Wisconsin and Michigan. He's ahead in both. Mm-hmm. If he wins them both, he's president.
She has how many?
187.
And he has?
She has 188. He has 187.
But he's ahead.
So she's winning.
Exactly. You know what?
She's up by one right now.
She should call it.
Exactly.
Done.
Let's end now. Does the election have a safe word? Pumpkin patch. Pumpkin patch. So is it, if you were going to put your money down right now, what would you say?
He's the favorite right now. He is. I mean, okay. She can still win.
How about you, John?
I think that's right. I think right now, even if you had to bet at this moment, he's a narrow favorite.
Whoever wins, it's going to be a really challenging time for America.
I think the diagnosis would be...
Good line for a comedy show, eh?
Yeah, right. No, I'm not sure if it's a comedy show at this point.
Yeah.
I think we're in the middle of a documentary right now.
I think...
Am I in your documentary right now?
Do something.
Is this just for Showtime?
Do something irresistible.
What?
Do something irresistible. You'll make it. Or you mean we're making up the results?
Into the documentary?
Yeah.
If Trump wins, how about bursting into tears and screaming for the next 45 minutes? What'd you want to say? What? Donald Trump has taken the state of Florida.
Right.
Okay, so that's been called.
He is now on the doorstep of 270 electoral votes.
Wow. That's a horrifying prospect. I can't put a happy face on that. And that's my job.
Outside of the Civil War, World War II, and including 9/11, this may be the most cataclysmic event the country's ever seen.
Okay, so here we are. Do we happen to know what the electoral count is right now?
216 to 188.
216 to 188.
Trump with 216.
When will we know?
Trump wins.
I'm sure networks are very hesitant to call it.
Right.
When do you think we'll know at this point?
If Trump is projected to win Wisconsin or Michigan, he'll almost certainly win. But we just don't know how quickly they're going to count in those states. And again, you know, there was a lot of talk leading up to today and today that if Trump lost, he would challenge the results.
Yes.
I think Hillary Clinton's going to be under a lot of pressure to challenge the results in any close state.
Really?
Yeah.
Right now, you have 72% of the vote is in Wisconsin, and Trump is up by 3 points.
Is that a lot?
Three?
Yeah.
It's 72?
It's enough for him to be president, yeah. There are combinations now that get him to 269.
Okay.
I mean, yes.
And then what happens if there are 269, 269?
Donald Trump is the president.
Why?
Because in a tie race like that, it goes to the House of Representatives, which is controlled by Republicans.
gets more fun all the time.
Right.
I'm so glad you guys are here. I wouldn't want to be alone right now. cheers. Thanks so much for being here. Thanks for the news, however upsetting it might be.
You don't mean any of that.
No, obviously, I'm very grateful that you're here. I'm going to finish this reel.
You can finish mine, too. I got to go back to work.
I don't think I could sit down right now. We still don't know, right?
Nope.
And we don't have any idea when it's going to be called. Okay, is there any polls? I mean, is it literally going to come down like Alaska and Hawaii and stuff like that? Because we never wait for those people. We don't know. We love them, but, you know, they're too far out west. Now, I think we can agree that this has been an absolutely exhausting, bruising election for everyone.
That's right.
And it has come to an ending that I did not imagine.